Hello students, now today we are going to talk about the structure of the eye. To see anything, you know, to see anything around us, we require two things. First of all, we require light, and you know about the light we have discussed in detail in this chapter. And the second thing which we require is eye. Now this is a wonderful gift which God has given to us, in absence of which we cannot see anything around us, isn't it? So you know, what is eye all about, like how can we see, what are the different parts of the eye? Let's talk about that. So I'll write here the structure of eye. And I'll draw a rough diagram of the eye so that you know we can understand the things little bit in a better way. So I'm drawing here. Structure of the eye. I'm just drawing, you know, a rough diagram so that just we can understand the parts what we need to know. Now see this outermost part, children. This outermost part is known as cornea. I'll just take one more minute to draw this, complete this. It has got many membranes, but we'll not talk about all that. Okay. So let's begin with the structure of the eye, children. Now, you all can see this part, children. This is an outer bulgy part of the eye. Now, this outer bulgy part of the eye can be known as the cornea. Now, this outermost bulgy part of the eye is known as cornea. Actually, whatever amount of light which enters into the eye, okay, whatever amount of light which is entering into our eye, enters from this bulgy part which is known as cornea, right? Now after this there is, you know, and this one is convex in you know shape, as we have studied. See, I'll not be discussing about, you know, the converging, diverging power, you know, and what is convex lens, not because we have discussed this thing in detail in the chapter. So the structure of eye we are talking about, and the eye works on the basis, you know, of the refraction. So we need to remember what is a refraction, and eye works upon a refraction. Now this outermost bulgy part is known as cornea, and light enters from this part. Now here, along with here, you know, like little bit behind the back side of the cornea is a flat, okay, which kind of structure? It is a flat and ring like membrane, actually. Okay, it is ring like membrane, and this part is known as iris. This part is known as iris. This is flat, ring like, and colored also, and it can be also known as diaphragm, right? It can be also known as diaphragm. Okay, so this is iris. Now after iris we have, actually, you know, between the iris I should say, there's a gap, right? And this gap is known as pupil. This gap is known as pupil. Now around here one lens is there, right? Now this cornea also, I told, it is bulgy, and the, you know, it is convex in shape, and even the lens is of convex shape, isn't it? I'll write over here, convex lens we have, right? Now this lens, how it is, you know, how it is fixed over here, with the help of what it is fixed over here. So here we have and from here we have got muscles and suspensory ligaments. So So right, so here yes, so these are the, you know, see the lens is fixed over here with the help of what? The lens is fixed over here. So here we have suspensory ligaments and the ciliary muscles. So this one is known as ciliary muscles and this one is known as suspensory ligaments. Right, so here we have got ciliary muscles to which, you know, suspensory ligaments are there. And how, like, see, if you want to know like how this lens is fixed over here, so this lens is fixed because the suspensory ligaments are holding the lens. Now the one end of the suspensory ligament is attached to the ciliary muscles and the other end of the suspensory ligament is attached to the lens, right? In this way the lens is fixed at its own place. Now this lens, what we are talking about, the eye lens, it is made up of, you know, it is a convex lens. And it is, what is the speciality of this? What are the special characteristics of this lens? So it is flexible, it is soft, it is jelly-like, and it is made up of protein. And one more very important thing is that the focal length, you know, what is the difference between the eye, human eye, and the camera is the focal length of the camera cannot be changed, right? The focal length of the camera cannot be changed, whereas the focal length of the eye can be changed. Now, how it happens, actually what we were discussing is about the lens. Like the lens is convex lens, it is flexible, soft, and is made up of jelly-like structure, jelly-like protein, like from protein, which is jelly like, right? Now the most important thing is that the thickness and thinness of this lens can be changed. Now we will talk about in the later part of the structure that how the thickness and thinness of the lens can be changed. So now here this will proceed with the structure of the eye. Now here this part behind the lens is the part which is known as retina. Now this part is known as retina. Now what is retina, children? It is a thin membrane. Okay, it is a thin membrane. It is a thin membrane and this is the place, okay, this is the place where the image formation takes place, right? Here the image formation takes place. And here the image formation takes place. Now this thin membrane, okay, this thin membrane has got certain cells, you know, certain cells in it, and these cells are rods and cones, right? We will discuss about this also in detail. Now, you know, here, this is one nerve which we can see here, one nerve is there. Now, this nerve is optic nerve. And this spot where this nerve is leaving the eye is known as blind spot. It is known as blind spot. I'll write here. So, you know, at anywhere at the, you know, on this membrane, if the image is formed, the eye will be able to see. But if the, you know, image formation takes place on this blind spot, the image formation, you know, the eye won't be able to see, because this is a part where these two cells, you know, these two cells, the rods and the cones, are not present, right? Now, so we'll talk about, see, this is a rough structure which we have discussed, the structure of the eye. We'll just detail it now. So what actually it is, what is the structure of the eye? See, this is the outermost part, this is the bulgy part, this is known as cornea. Whatever light is entering into the eye, it enters into the eye from this part which is known as cornea, right? Now after this, you know, the first only, the converging of light takes place from the cornea, right? We have discussed this, that what is convergence and divergence. So the first convergence, when the light enters into the eye, takes place from this cornea only, the first convergence of the light. Now after this, you know, is the eyelids which we close. As you know, when we talk about the camera, the shutter is there. When the shutter gets closed, the light cannot enter the camera. In the same way, when the eyelids are closed, the light cannot enter into eye, isn't it? So this is cornea. After this, there is a colored and a, you know, ring like membranous structure, and which is colored also, and this is known as iris, and this iris can also be known as diaphragm. Now here, now we have got, you know, ciliary muscles. Now ciliary muscles are attached to the suspensory ligaments, and then we have got lens. Now how the lens is at one place, how is it stable at one place? So this is happening because of the ciliary muscles and suspensory ligaments. So this suspensory ligaments, what it is doing, it is holding this, you know, from one side it is attached to the lens, and from the other side it is attached to the ciliary muscles. Here, over here also, the one end of the suspensory ligaments, you know, it is attached to the lens, and from the other side it is attached to the ciliary muscles. Now after this, you know, lens is like, it is flexible and it is soft. And the main thing is that the thickness and thinness of the lens can be changed. The thickness and thinness can be changed. And this is the biggest difference which we have between the eye and the human eye and the camera. Now this membrane is known as retina. This is a very thin membrane where the image formation takes place. Here one nerve is there which is known as optic nerve, and the spot, the point from where this optic nerve is leaving the eye, is known as blind spot. If the image formation takes place at the blind spot, eye cannot see it. Now retina has got two very important cells, and these cells are known as rods and cones. Now what are these rods and cones, children? Rods are definitely, these are rod shaped structure, and they are sensitive to the dim light. They are sensitive to the dim light. That means they become, they will work in presence of dim light, right? Now there are certain animals, children, which can see at the night time. Like we can talk about the nocturnal animals, like the owl and, you know, the other animals. Most of the animals can see at night time, and we cannot see, you know, in the dark. Because the reason is here that we have got very less number of rods in our retina, whereas these all animals have got more. Like when we talk about the owl, it has got many, or you know, lot of rods, cells in the retina. Now so these cells become active in the dim light only. Now when we talk about the cones, children, definitely these are of cone shape. But you know, this become, you know, active, they do not become active in the dim light, and they require bright light. Okay, so they require bright light. They become active in the bright light, and they are responsible for the color differentiation. We are able to see, children, different kind of colors, isn't it? We are able to see, you know, all different kind of colors. So why is it possible for us to, you know, differentiate, to see the colors and to differentiate between them? It is all possible to see and to understand and to differentiate the different colors because of the presence of the cone cells in our eye, in the retina, right? So these are two very important cells which makes it possible for us to see. Now what is happening actually, you know, when we talk about these cells. So you know, these cells, when the light for, when the image formation takes place, these cells become active, right? So these cells become active, and they generate an electrical electrical message, or electrical signals are being generated. Electrical signals are generated, and these electrical signals, you know, are being transferred by retina to the brain. From the retina, it travels to the brain, right? And in this way, the brain gets the signals and interpret it as the vision. Okay, so brain interpret as the vision. Now, very important thing, children. Now, when we talk, when we say that this lens is a convex lens, we are saying that this lens is convex lens. So, definitely, which kind of image will be formed over here? Whenever it is, whenever the lens is convex, so we all have discussed which kind of image formation will take place. Real image will form, will be formed, and along with that, the inverted image will be formed. Real and inverted image will be formed, but you know what? Whatever we are seeing, okay, then you know it should be inverted only. But why it is not happening? So why are we and how are we able to see the real image? See what actually is happening is here on this membrane, the inverted image is only formed, right? But when the you know when this message when here, when the image formation takes place, the cells become active, the electrical cells, you know, signals are generated. These electrical signals are being sent to the brain through this optic nerve, and there it is being, you know, interpreted as the, you know, vision, as it is, you know, converted into a, you know, the erect image by the brain. But here the image formation, which kind of image will form, children? Here the real image, but it will be inverted image, right? Now what is happening, you know, when we suddenly, you know, you might have observed that whenever we go suddenly to a dark place, like say for example when we go to the cinema hall, for a few seconds we won't be able to see, isn't it? For a few minutes you won't be able to see things very properly, but you know, as the passage of time, within few seconds, you know, the things become little clearer to us. So, and vice versa, you know, when we come out from the cinema hall, we come out in the bright light, we won't be able to see, you know, like there's a glare in the eye and we are not able to open our eyes properly. So, why is it happening, children? Because, you know, this iris is the one which controls the, you know, the amount of light which is coming into the eye, isn't it? So what iris is doing and what all is happening over here is actually, you know, what happens when the when there is, you know, bright light, when we are standing in the bright light, so this iris has gotten, you know, you know, power to adjust the you know, to adjust the lens, right? So what is happening, not lens actually, sorry, pupil. So what is happening actually when there is, you know, lot of light, so the pupil, the size of the pupil becomes small, alright. What is happening when lot of light is there, when bright light is there, when bright light is there, so our pupil will become small or get contracted. It will become small, and when the pupil will become small, so obviously little less amount of light will be entering into our eye. Now when dark is there, when darkness is there, what happens, the iris you know adjusts in such a way that pupil become get enlarged. Now what actually is happening, you know, when we are standing in the you know, bright light, so what is happening, the already like lot of light is coming to the eye, so the pupil needs to be little smaller only, so that little less light should enter in eye, so pupil is small. So when we, from the bright light, when we go to the dark, are you all getting my point? When we are standing in the bright, now suppose see there lot of light over here, so what is happening, the size of the pupil has become little small. And the size of the pupil has become little small, so lesser amount of light is entering into eye, into our eye. Okay, so now when the lesser amount of eye is entering, because we do not require, because so much of light is already there. Now from in this situation, with our pupil small only, when we go to the dark room, when we go to the cinema hall, the pupil is small, less amount of light will enter, and so we are not able to see, you know, things very clearly. But you know, gradually what happens, you know, it takes little time, it takes little few seconds, you know, to this adjustment of the pupil, you know, isn't it? So it takes little time. So by this time, as we enter into the you know, dark room, what will happen, automatically the iris will allow the pupil get to get enlarged. Okay, now pupil will get enlarged, and so more amount of light will enter into eye, and so again we will be able to see. Now, dark in the sense I am talking about the cinema hall. Okay, now again we'll take the vice versa. Now, when we are standing, when we are there in the dark room, okay, when we are there in the cinema hall, so our pupil is large, isn't it? Pupil is large, that so that more amount of light can enter in our eye. Now, and in this situation only, with a enlarged pupil, when we go out, so now there is a bright sunlight or whatever, there is a lot of light outside, our pupil is enlarged, and so we feel glare. Okay, we are not able to open our eyes because suddenly lot of light is entering into eye. So what will happen again? The pupil, the iris will contract the pupil, isn't it? So this is how the iris, it arranges it, the size of the the pupil depends upon the iris, and in this way the with the contraction and relaxation of the pupil, the amount of light which is coming to our eye get adjusted every now and then. Okay, now what is happening, here rods and cons also we have studied, like what is all, like how the colored can be differentiated by the cons, and how like these rods, why we are not able to see in the night as properly as the owls and the nocturnal animals can see, because we have very lesser number of rods, and the cones cannot get activated in the dim light, they will get activated in the bright light only. And that is the reason when we drive at night, so we won't be able to see, I'm talking about when we drive at night, so we won't be able to see the colors of the car, isn't it? Becomes a little difficult to drive at night time, because definitely we'll be able to identify, like, yeah, the car is coming, this is coming, that is coming, but we won't be able to identify the colors, right? That which color car is approaching towards us, we cannot identify the colors. Why? Because cones are not sensitive to the dim light, they require bright light. That means we require bright light to differentiate and to identify the colors. Right, now we'll talk about the different things which are related to the structure of eye only. Okay, so now what is the role of the ciliary muscles and the suspensory ligaments? So now we'll talk about this, and I can say, like, we'll be talking about the power of accommodation now. Now, what is the power of accommodation, children? And what is the role of the ciliary muscles and the suspensory ligaments? We'll talk about that. So now, what is happening actually is, how it gets, how the lens becomes thick and how the lens become thin, and what is the role of all this? We are going to talk about this.